Oh my word, look at this, everyone. These lions just managed to catch a young calf. This is incredible. We did it. We couldn't see them for a second, and we caught a glimpse of one lioness stalking the herd. Remember, I said these buffalo had moved almost directly in, straight towards the lionesses or the lions. And the next thing, we heard them running, caught a glimpse of a lioness, and we just heard the distress call from the buffalo. We've driven in here now, they've managed to pull down this young buffalo. This is incredible. Absolutely incredible. Watch how that male has got a chokehold on the buffalo, trying to suffocate it and also prevent it from calling, because usually what happens if that buffalo gives off the distress call, the rest of the herd will come back and try and help it. That was incredibly quick. Literally from seeing the buffalo running to these lions moving into the area, it was incredibly fast. Must have been 2 minutes, 3 minutes. This isn't always easy to see, but we need to remember this is nature and these animals do need to eat. And as you were saying, the lions are doing very well with hunting buffalo at the moment. And these lionesses are quite fortunate to have this male around, because he's really powerful and able to help hold and kill this buffalo. The other lioness just off to the right, and she's actually watching the rest of the herd. Can see the herd in the distance. See how she's poised and focused. Now, probably almost 100 meters ahead of her, the rest of the herd is right there. This is that male with that very nasty scar gash around the face. Oh, doesn't look very good at all. But I do think that if he carries on eating and perhaps cleaning it, maybe the other lions clean it too, then he may heal quite quickly. His animals have the amazing ability to heal very quickly. See how that lioness is starting to feed on the rump? That's where a lot of the soft meat is. So it's easier to get a good bit of meat and get into the carcass. Really happened so quickly. Brian and I didn't see the actual takedown. We just heard, we could see the lions run, heard the buffalo running, and we heard the quick distress call, that very, very distinct buffalo distress call. And we drove in here quickly, and as we got here, they'd already brought it down. So quick, so efficient. It was amazing. Christine just made a comment and said she wishes they could find a way to kill them faster. And Christine, I know it is sometimes difficult to watch And it depends. Usually, I mean, smaller prey, they are able to kill a lot quicker, but it might be a little bit difficult. Maybe this male isn't really getting that chokehold right. And yeah, but again, you know, this is nature, and it's not always pleasant to watch, and nature can be harsh, but it is survival. It really is amazing that we're able to bring this to you live, and as we're seeing it, you're seeing it. This, you know, that's what I find so fascinating about safari life. You watch a lot of documentaries and you see hunts and kills, and a lot of those, they take 2 to 3 years to film. This we are all, we're seeing literally right now. So, oh, that male's getting a bit aggressive. The other lioness just took off. She's chasing the herd again. But if they're not careful, they may lose this buffalo. And it's amazing. We spoke about how opportunistic they are. Even though they've got a kill, they will still try and hunt something else. So Maria's asked, how long does it usually take for a buffalo to die? Maria, it all depends. Like I say, occasionally it can be quick, 5 minutes, 2 to 5 minutes. If they get the correct hold, I would have thought they would have killed this younger buffalo a bit quicker. And the male's still trying to choke it, but I don't think he's got a... those lionesses are playing again. I think they'll probably return back to this carcass. So Maria, it all varies. It can vary quite a bit, but generally 5-10 minutes, sometimes longer, depends if it's a big buffalo bull. I've seen lions though with smaller prey, and they, for example, an impala, they hunt that and they literally kill them on impact. They hit them so hard. I think this, it looks like this buffalo is dead now. No, jeez. Still, oh my word. I thought it had stopped kicking there for a second. But look how powerful that male is, able to turn that buffalo almost right around. I'm surprised these lionesses haven't returned. See, and it's interesting, it's almost like they don't want to share the meal with the male, so they probably think, well, this male's going to feed here. Let's see if we can't find another buffalo and have our own kill. But, wow, look, it's amazing to watch the struggle. This is incredible. Brenda's asked us a question, and why haven't the lionesses come back to help kill this buffalo, perhaps a bit quicker and bite it around the nose or the mouth to suffocate it a bit quicker? Brenda, I think because they've got it down already, and it's very difficult to say. I think because they've got it down, the male is on it, they know that the buffalo's got no chance of getting up and running away. So they're almost happy to start feeding or move on. Like I said, they've followed the rest of the herd now. Can't see them anymore. They've moved off through a thicket. But they probably know, well, this male has got this buffalo, so there's no need to worry too much about it. Wow, look how he's lifting that buffalo up. Incredibly powerful. As I said again earlier, you know, they're so opportunistic, even though they've got food right here, because there's still the potential chance of catching more around just around the corner, those lionesses have gone and they're trying their luck. They're going to try and see if they can't get more. Michael, Michael has asked us, and good morning to you, Michael. Michael's asked us a question about these Birmingham males, these big dominant males. Why does it seem like they don't help hunt as much, or have we just not seen it? So, Michael, I mean, we didn't see this kill exactly. I think what probably happened is lioness cornered or caught the buffalo. And as soon as they got it, the male ran in and brought it down. But I'm not too sure. We didn't see it. So in a way, they definitely help. And he's holding this buffalo down now. Perhaps those lionesses will return later. If they realize they can't hunt anymore, they might return. But he is definitely helping with the kill. I mean, he's basically doing the killing now. Not a great job, but he is responsible for it. So, and male lions generally help with the larger prey. So buffalo, giraffe, anything really big, that's what they'll help with. Whereas the lionesses, if they're hunting any antelope, they're powerful enough to bring it down and kill it themselves. So they don't need the help from the males. Also, the thing is, you need to remember these males stand out a little bit more. These big manes, a bit easier to spot. It's not always easy for them to hunt. They do hunt for themselves, though. I mean, if there are no lionesses around, they have to hunt. So they will hunt for themselves. Going to try see if we can work out which direction those lionesses have gone. We'll stick with this male also, just to make sure he has killed it. And you never know, we could get some other lions joining. While I do that, let's get an update from Taylor and see if those lions are moving.